Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn the third poem from standard 8.1.3, The Pilgrim. This is an inspirational and a touching poem. The poet is anonymous, means we do not know much more about the poet. Through this poem, the poet has mentioned the generosity of the first pilgrim. See the actual poem. A pilgrim going a lone highway came at evening cold and gray to a chasm deep and vast and wide. The old man crossed in the twilight dim. The chasm held no fear for him, but he paused when he reached the other side and built a bridge to span the tide. In this first stanza, the poet says, a pilgrim who was going a lone highway. Lone means single, lonely highway. And that pilgrim came at evening cold and grey. The atmosphere was cold, grey, nervous, disappointed. The pilgrim reached to a chasm. Chasm means a very deep, steep gap in the earth's surface. That chasm was deep and vast and wide. The old man crossed in the twilight dim. So before night, in the evening, as the sun was going to set, there was a twilight. And in this twilight, the old man, that is the pilgrim, crossed the chasm. The chasm held no fear for him. The chasm could not frighten him, could not make him afraid. But he paused. Pause means took a stop for some time. When he reached the other side, when the first pilgrim reached the other side of the chasm, he paused for some time there and built a bridge to span the tide. Span the tide is a phrase. It means go across the tide. So the poet said that the first pilgrim, when he reached the other side of the chasm, he paused there and he built a bridge to span the tide. To go across the tide, to cross the difficult valley. At that moment, old man, said a fellow pilgrim near. There was nearby another one fellow pilgrim. He said to the first pilgrim, old man, why waste your time in building here? Asked that, why are you wasting your time in building this bridge here? As you have crossed the chasm, your journey ends with the close of the day. And the fellow pilgrim asked to the old pilgrim that your journey, your traveling ends, finished with the close of the day. Then why are you again building a bridge here? You never again will pass this way. You are not going to pass this way again. So why are you going to build the bridge? You have crossed the chasm deep and wide. The fellow pilgrim said that you have already crossed the chasm, which was deep and wide. Why build ye here at eventide? Ye is an archaic word in the last line. Ye means you. And eventide means late evening. So, in the second stanza, the fellow pilgrim asked the old pilgrim that why are you wasting your time in building the bridge? You are not going to come by this way anymore. The pilgrim raised his old gray head. The old pilgrim raised his old gray head and said, my friend, in the path I have come, he said. My friend, I have come in this path. There followeth after me today
And he said, after me, there might be another one young pilgrim who want to cross this charm, a fair-haired youth, that is, a young one, who must pass this way. The chance which held no fears for me. And he said that this chance which did not frighten me, which could not make me afraid. So this chance to the fair-haired youth may a pitfall be. So he said to the young pilgrim who is inexperienced, this chance must be a pitfall. It may be a trap for a young pilgrim. He too must cross in the twilight dim. And he mentioned the reason in the last two lines and says that I am building this bridge so that the young pilgrim must cross this chasm in the twilight dim. My friend, I am building this bridge for him. Thank you.